Welcome, welcome, welcome everyone, MB Wilkiller over here. We gonna do a vid today about the M Wilkiller indicator. Yes, I said that I wouldn't do a vid about it anymore, but I'm getting so much questions about this indicator, and well, I decided to do a vid about it, and I think that a lot of people will get a lot of help trading it and even make a lot of money. And yes, I will say this, and I will say it, and I'm very confident about it. This indicator is better than any paid indicator in the world, meaning there are indicators for $1,000, $700, $500 a year. Some indicators are even more. And I've tried them all. At least the ones that are available on the markets and are getting sold and shilled on whatever. So I've tried them all. And I can proudly say I created this indicator and tested it on myself, and I'm the creator of this indicator, and I can proudly say it's the best. It's the best indicator out there. Okay, well, now you guys can say, wait a minute, M Wilkiller, MB, why you created this indicator and you're telling us that it's the best? That's a lot of crap you're saying at this moment, because if this indicator is the best, other people should say that it's the best and not you. Well, there are a lot of people that are saying that it's the best, but I am no company. I am no shiller. And most importantly of all, I am not selling this indicator. I am giving it to the retail fam, to the retailers in the world for free. So you're not going to pay me whatever for this indicator. And in this vid, I'm going to explain you guys why it's the best. Because, you know, there are a lot of paid indicators, and I can use any indicator out there of those indicators, and I can show you that it's working very good. But I can also show you that it's working not good. I'm not going to call it a scam, because sure, there could be some good things on those indicators, but why would you pay money to get something that's better and it's for free? So that's something I'm going to talk about today, and I'm going to show you guys why this indicator is the best out there for traders, for scalpers, for long-term investors. And I'm gonna show you guys a lot of things, and you can decide for yourself if this indicator is good or not. And I'm not selling it to you, so the only thing that I ask in return for this indicator is that you guys tell me in the comments if it's good or not. And if you're using it, if there are viewers that are using it, please do share your experience with it. I'm not going to pay anyone to say something, because I've never paid anyone. I've never been paid by anyone to say something. So I'm also never going to pay anyone to say something or whatever. It's just pure, natural actions. So this is what we're going to do in this vid. So everyone that does agree with me after me showing you how this indicator works, and even if you've tested it, the only thing I ask in return, please leave a comment. Leave a comment and share the vid. A like, share the vid. Let's grow as a retail community. I'm giving so much, and I need to get something back from you guys. And back from you guys doesn't mean that you guys have to pay me money. I don't need your money. I just want you guys, it's just for free. Click on the damn like button and share the vid on Twitter, on YouTube, on whatever. And share it also to your family, to your friends. And show people how they can protect themselves from getting wrecked. That's all that I'm asking. Let's dive in. Indicator. This is the indicator. Okay. Let's just test it and see what it's doing. This is on the 1 hour time frame. By the way, this indicator works on all time frames. So, for example, what we're seeing here, we're seeing on the NASDAQ, for example. Guys, by the way, I'm gonna randomly choose any chart out there, anything, and I will show you on any chart how it works. So, while we're watching the NASDAQ, I've tweeted this a week ago or something, before Powell's speech was going to happen and the rate decision. I told you guys there is going to be a pre-pump 2 days before, and exactly how I predicted it, it happened. Did I expect the pump to be as big as it is now? No, I didn't expect that by far. The team shorted the NASDAQ exactly when I told them to short it, and they took profits yesterday, exactly at the right moment before the markets opened, and they jumped out. And over here, I also shared this in this region over here yesterday in the TG group, that the profits they took, they put in back in the short. So they are in a short. They are building their shorts. But let me show you guys what happened. Look at this indicator. We go back in time, back in time, back in time, back in time. Over here. Over here, the indicator was getting rejected here. We came back up, up, close below, above it, below it. You have to see, this is the 200 EMA, guys. This is also a very, very, very important one. Everyone trading should have the 200 EMA on his chart. By the way, guys, there are more indicators that you should have. The most important one, important ones, are the 50 MA, are the 100 MA, are the 200 EMA. These are very important indicators to have on your chart when you're charting. So, okay, let's dive in. So, rejected, 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 and then above it. So over here, there was not a lot happening, but you can put it on the 4 hour. There you see another picture. Then you see, okay, we lost it over here, boom. Came back, rejected, 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 fighting, and boom, it went up. So let's go back to the 1 hour. 1 hour. Over here, we broke the indicator. This was bullish number one. And we also broke the 200 EMA. We came back, tested it as support. And from here on, this was, guys, this was on the 1st of November. This was when the FOMO hit in. Just like I predicted on my Twitter that they would, 2 days before Powell, they're going to pump the markets. It's really, guys, I'm no oracle. It's just based on pure knowledge and pure experience in trading. We tested it, and this is when those Wall Street bulls started to pump, 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 pump. Look at the indicator. Pump, 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 pump. Over here, we came back to the indicator. Whoa, the wheels are like, wait a minute, we need to pump again. Boom, off she went. Pump, 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 pump. Over here, they came back. Look, guys, this is no coincidence. I did not draw this thing. This thing has been here. Exactly. Look at it. Just look. It's not science. It's just pure facts. Look. Do you think that this is coincidence? Do you think that this is coincidence? Wait a minute. Indicator will start pump, pump, pump. Back, back, back. Look at it here again. Over here. Oh, wait a minute. We're reaching the indicator. Boom. Off we went again. Today, this is present, this is now happening. Look at it. Down, 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 down. Exactly at the indicator. Boom. They pumped it up again. So, what does this mean? What does this mean? This means that it's like those wheels are like having this same indicator on their screen, and they're trading, waiting, it goes up, waiting. When it reaches the indicator, we go pump again. And at some point, yes, they're gonna lose it at some point, but then they will flip again, because let me show you on a downside. On the downside, over here. We came down, up, down, and here is where it happened. Rejected, 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 rejected. Look at it, rejected. Over here we closed above it, but we were under the 200 EMA. So this is an invalidation, because if you want to have it valid, if you're trading, it needs to get above this if you want a long. So rejected, rejected on the 200 EMA. Rejected, 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 rejected. Over here we break up. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. Was a bit of chopping around. 200 EMA, rejected. Okay, there we go again. Under it, rejection. And then, boom, down we go. Again, test it, rejected, boom, down again. Over here we went up it, this was a fake out, and we went, because there, over here, when you see the choppings around, over here, this is where you have to be cautious, because over here, it's just up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. You also have got these moments. When these moments happen, it's very hard to trade the indicator when you're trading on the short term. So you have to put it on lower time frames to trade this. But at the 1 hour, it was just chopping around, chopping around, chopping around, and then over here was the pump. So a lot of you guys will say, okay, well, MB, nice, but that's the NASDAQ. But most of your followers are crypto traders. Okay. Let's go to oh, this was beautiful, by the way, this one. See, share this over here. Yes, let me remove this drawer. It's all about the indicator today. Okay, Bitcoin over here, we lost the indicator, could be a short, but the 200 EMA is still below it. So this is, you have to see it like this. You've got the indicator, and the 200 EMA is like the second defense line. We broke above, below it, boom, down, down, down. And this is something in trading, guys, that you have to be, you have to learn. When you see below it, bulls push it up. Bulls keep it up. Below it, bulls close it up. Up, up. Retest, retest. Bulls just won't let the price on the 1 hour, the Bitcoin price, close below the 200 EMA. This means that there is a bullish momentum creating over here. They just won't let it close below it. That's something that I'm eyeing. And then, boom, we got this pump, and then boom, they pumped it through the indicator into the, and then you got this movement over here. And now we came back, and guys, again, I did not prepare this. I just put on a chart. Look at it. Indicator, boom, up. Indicator, boom, up. Guys, this is no coincidence. This is no coincidence. That's why I'm proudly to say this is by far the best indicator in the world. And I'm very proud to be the one that created and made it. I made it all by myself. I've got 100% ownership of this indicator. And it's for me, free to everyone in the world that is watching my vid. It's free. You can use it for yourself and test it out and whatever. So, okay, MB, well, this was Bitcoin. Show us some other coin. Show us anything. Well, I've got a list of coins here. Just name one. Let me put on Engine. As you can see, when you go to, when you go to altcoins, altcoins are more volatile. So meaning that the indicator works, but it doesn't work as much as on Bitcoin or indexes or the USD or DXY or whatever. So the bigger the market cap is of an asset, the better this indicator works. When you've got some altcoin, altcoins are very low cap altcoins, and it's also more manipulators are in play. So you have to be very cautious over here. But let's just check it. Let's just check it. Over here, we break above it, came back, retest. You see, it's holding, 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 holding. Off we go. We came back, tested perfectly. Off we go. Tested it perfectly. Off we go. And over here, we closed below it. This was bearish. But the reason why we didn't continue down is because Bitcoin pumped. And a lot of altcoins are really, in case you don't know, this is a crypto trader. Altcoins are related to Bitcoin. So if Bitcoin pumps, altcoins pump. If Bitcoin dumps, altcoin dumps. Not in all cases, but 99% of the cases, this is how it is. So that's why we saw this, because when this thing was getting bearish to come down and Bitcoin decides to pump all of a sudden, this thing will go up also. So this is the, okay, let me use another one. Let me go to XRP. Let us just use XRP. Over here, momentum. We got the momentum over here. Boom, up. Test, test. Over here, test, test. Up, 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 up. Over here, we got boom, this dump. I don't know why this dump happened, by the way, but this is crypto, guys. Crypto is very volatile. And over here, when we close below it, this was resistance, 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 resistance. And over here, when we went up it, this is again Bitcoin that made that pump, and all these altcoins pump with it. Let me go to Chainlink. Link, same. Pump up, back, hold, hold, pump, pump, pump. Hold, 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 pump, hold, hold, pump. So as you can see, the bulls, I don't know what it is, but it's like they have the same indicator over here, or they have the same price action. I don't know what it is, but every time when this thing, when it's in an uptrend, when it comes to it, there is a very high chance that they will pump it up again. And when we're going down, it's the same story. It acts as resistance. So when it comes near it, it goes down. So let me show you guys another. This is a coin that someone in the TG group has pointed out today. If someone is trading it, let me put it on the 4 hour. What can we see over here? Boom, the momentum came in. This was the pump up. Back, test, 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 boom, test, test, boom. Guys, I don't know how much more I need to show you. I can show you any asset out there in the world. This indicator is by far the best indicator in the world. And I'm not going to make a long video, almost 80 minutes. Guys, if you want this indicator, we've got an open TG group, and you can find the indicator code over there. It's not on TradingView. You cannot find it on TradingView on Amwell Killer Indicator, although I've added it. TradingView, the Pine Editor team over there, they decided to block my indicator. They didn't. They gave me like 1,000 reasons why they wouldn't allow it to be available to the people. And why? House rumors, this, that, whatever, whatever, whatever. I'm not going to even try to understand what they're telling me over there. I sent them, like, I'm also a partner with TradingView, and I've told them, listen, this is just an indicator I created for myself to help retailers trade, and they just won't allow it. So I gave up on that point. If you want to use it, there is a code. You can paste it yourself in the TG group. Maybe there are some members over there that can help you if you don't know how it works, if you don't know how to create, how to get it on, because this is the one, and this is the code, and this is how you can get. So we also have our trading group. Soon we're gonna start a trading group, the MaxC Global. So we're gonna trade on MaxC. Why are we going to trade on MaxC? Because it has got by far the lowest fees. So it's really a no-brainer. I'm getting crazy thinking about this. How is it possible that people still trade on other exchanges? I really don't understand. You're paying 70, 80, 90, 100% more fees than on Maxi. And am I saying that Maxi is a 100% secure exchange? No, they all are not. So if you're trading crypto, it's always a risk. Always a risk. If you want security, I've got my Bitfavo link. It's also over there. It's just for spot trading. And I, let me just say, it's the only exchange I know from where I can sleep at night, and I know that my funds are safe. I don't have to worry about them. But if you are trading whatever exchange out there, it's always a risk. But for me, if I'm gonna risk something, why should I pay 40, 50, 60, 70 bucks on one trade that I made in an hour? Well, I can do it on Maxi for maybe $5 or $4. It's madness. I really don't understand how people trade on other exchange. I really don't get it. And you don't have to trust me on my word. Just go test it yourself. I've got a link below. If you want to, we have a friends group on the TG group. If you want to come in, you can use the link. You can make an account and you can deposit just a small amount just to test it. Test, just like, for example, guys, what I did. This is what I did. Because I've partnered up with Maxi, but I didn't, it's not that they reached out to me. I was the one that did my research, and I was the one that shilled Maxi because of the low fees. So what happened is this: I had 100 bucks on one exchange. I'm not going to name any other exchange, by the way. One exchange, but this is a very famous one, and I think that 70-80% of retailers are in this two exchanges. And I used Maxi, and what I did was very simple. I had $100, and I started to trade on futures. I don't trade leverage, it was just to test it. So I did a market buy here, market buy there, and I did a market sell there, a market sell there. And then I went into my fees that I paid. Guys, I was shocked. The difference is huge. Huge, huge. And there are a lot of people telling me, well, wait a minute, MB, there's not a lot of liquidity on Maxi. No, that's also not true. Sure, those other ones have got much more liquidity. But when I tested, for example, the USDT Perpetual, Maxi had even more liquidity, what I could see. So not what the data is showing us, it's what we are live seeing, had more liquidity than one of the biggest of the other ones. And I don't know how they make those data about liquidity, because in my opinion, it's all crap. Because when I'm seeing live, I'm seeing like 100 Bitcoin getting traded in like 2 minutes, and I see at the other exchange, I see maybe something like 30 or 40 Bitcoin getting traded. It's very, very, very strange to me. So Maxi is by far the lowest fee. So if you want to join us, you can use the Maxi link. You can also use the TG link. By the way, I'm gonna share the TG link today in my vid. So you can join us over there, because I always forget to put my TG group. It's on my Twitter, by the way. So if you're watching this vid, you should for sure follow me on Twitter, because on Twitter is where I share everything I do. Okay, guys, we managed to get it at 25 minutes. Indicator, if you're not using it or you don't not having it, you are a thief of your own pockets, like we say in Dutch. In Dutch we say, je bent een dief van je eigen portemonnee. So you're a thief of your own pockets. And for sure, guys, you'll say something like, wait a minute, Will Killer, Retail Army, what is that? A Twitter account, 5k followers or 6k followers. Okay, well, fine. It will probably be a lot of shit over there, and it's probably nothing, because we like to follow those guys that got a million followers, because they are the best. That's why they got a million followers, and we need to follow that famous one, because why? He went to the Bitcoin conference, and he went to there, and whatever out there, and so they are great. Yes, they are great in making you poor. Because it's all marketing, and it's all commercial, and it's all sponsorship, and it's all a lot of blah, 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 blah. That's what it is. So it's not about me. When you want to follow Alpha, follow the small ones. Follow the small ones. There are a lot of small accounts on Twitter, and they have a small followers, but they share pure alpha. I'm a professional trader. I can tell you now, right now, that 99% of the guys on Twitter, etc., that have got 300, 500k plus followers, most of them are all shit. And for sure, they've got big teams, and they've got a lot of people that can bring you a lot of alpha, and they've got research teams. I agree. And they do, if you're really in fundamentals, they do share a lot of information. So I'm not telling you to not follow this guy or not watch them. Watch them, because they have the money to create content, and the content that they create, as long as it's not paid. So make that for sure, that's not paid. So it's, if it's alpha, that's not paid, no sponsorships, and they share information about altcoins and fundamentals and etc. For sure, watch it. But if you're really based on trading and making money, that's where you have to watch out, because they are not specialized in trading. They are not specialized in how to make money. They are specialized in giving you commercial content. So you're going to watch again, and they're going to make a show where there are giveaways, where you can use the referral links, where you can use whatever paid program, where you can do this, where you can do that. It's like a business. Every business in the world is out there to make money. Every business out there is to make money. They are the same. I know some personally, and I've talked to them. And they tell me, MB, we have like 70, 80, 90, 100 people working for us. And we've got to pay these people. How do we pay them? Yeah, they pay them by selling a lot of referrals and sponsorships and whatever out there. Because that's the only way for them to survive. So think about this. Think about this. Why are you in these markets? Are you in these markets to whatever, to make companies rich, or are you in these markets to make money? And if you want to make money, follow the small accounts, because most of them really share alpha. Thank you very much, and have a nice one, and bye bye.